Police have taken decisive action in the war against youth crime, dragging eight teenagers from a Gold Coast hotel. They'd allegedly bragged on social media during a wild ride in a stolen car.
But they hadn't counted on the owner, a single mum from Brisbane's north side, tracking them down. Only 7 News was there for the dramatic arrests.
Checking out of the Mantra Circle on Cavill.
North side on top.
Before being checked in to the watch house. One after another, 8 teens cuffed, arrested and marched out of their glitzy Gold Coast hotel.
Did you have a good stay last night?
Yeah, I had a mad stay, bro.
Yeah, what'd you get up to?
None of your.
Police raided their hotel room this morning, finding keys to a stolen Honda Civic and other property.
Why'd you come down to the Gold Coast?
Because I like the Gold Coast, mate. We love running them,
really.
Single mother Tyler Howard owns the Civic. It was stolen from her Griffin home early Tuesday morning, along with her $1,500 Louis Vuitton handbag.
I was home. I was asleep in my bed when they came in and ransacked the place.
Her car found abandoned in Narangba today, and her belongings scattered at the Nudge boat ramp.
I want to get this to the cop shop now.
But it was this video posted online which led to the arrests.
Simo.
Allegedly behind the wheel, 18-year-old Dylan Simmons flaunting a Louis Vuitton handbag on the hotel balcony, even allegedly trying to sell it.
They obviously don't care, they don't have any remorse, they don't want to change.
This morning, he was in handcuffs, the handbag taken too.
My mate would definitely get a good price for it.
7 News understands the group was celebrating a birthday when officers turned up. They say some of the teens were in a daze.
I just hope that, you know, police, you know, really crack down, or like the court system really cracks down on their behaviour.
Now, police are yet to lay charges for 7 of those teens, ranging between 14 and 17. 18-year-old Dylan Simmons has now been slapped with 3 charges, including burglary and the unlawful use of a motor vehicle. He'll appear before a magistrate in Southport tomorrow.
Thank you, Jordan. And pressure is mounting on the state government to release a crucial review into measures to tackle youth crime. Bail laws and ankle monitors are in the spotlight as a teenager is charged over a terrifying attempted carjacking.
In the face of a carjacking, the feeling of fear matched the chilling sound.
Talk about it.
Behind the screams, former Matilda Alicia Canavis, live on radio, charged over the attack of a 14-year-old with a lengthy rap sheet, 3 counts of armed robbery, 2 counts of unlawful use of a motor vehicle, 1 count of burglary.
Here we go again, and we'll be back here until the laws are changed.
We have some of the strongest youth justice laws in the country.
Since February last year, just 8 repeat offenders have been fitted with ankle monitors, and a crucial review sits with government hidden from the public.
Of course we want to see the report. The government promised to release the report.
Other victims want action too.
It's not working, the whole bail system in that sense, is it?
Luke McCarrick clung to the bonnet of this stolen car on the Gold Coast for 7 kilometres after it rammed his vehicle.
Did you see that? There is a guy on the bonnet of that car.
It was horrific. It was really horrific how easily your life can be taken away.
A painful thought, now an agonising reality for the family of 59-year-old Michael Warburton, fatally struck by 4 teenagers in an alleged stolen car.
As the shrine continues to grow for the diehard Panthers fan, the fate of his alleged killers remains a secret, with media shut out of the court hearing. Why is a question that keeps being deflected.
When quizzed yesterday, the Youth Justice Minister said,
it's a question better put to the Attorney General.
The Attorney General's office pointed us back to the Justice Department. Neither minister prepared to answer the tough questions. Garth Burley, 7 News.